rifle, pistol, police.
Hey everyone, welcome back to Fallout 3. I'm up by Clifftop Shacks, and on the last episode, I had already crossed this bridge and come further along, but my game crashed. I think it tends to do that after I've been recording for a long period of time, and then don't stop and then let things catch up. So, we're continuing on to Oasis. Got a couple more side quests. It should be this one and then one other one, and then we can get back to the main story. Right around here, too. Ironically, it was in the middle of a quick save operation. Must be caravan merchants down there. Or scroungers. Tell me I'm not gonna get stuck down here. We could say off the beaten path. Try going up this way. I just approached it from the wrong side. Looks like it. There we go.
Outsider, you have arrived. Please come closer. I have something of the utmost urgency to speak to you about. Do hurry. He doesn't like to be kept waiting.
Okay.
I'm so glad you're here. It's been a while since anyone's visited us. And he's been waiting for someone like yourself to arrive. If you wouldn't mind following me, I'll bring you right to him.
And they capitalize him.
Who are you?
I'm sorry. In my excitement, I got ahead of myself. I'm Tree Father Birch, and I have the great fortune of being leader of his people, the Tree Minders. Beyond that gate is our home, Oasis.
Who's waiting for me?
Why, he is, of course.
Is that code
if you'll
for you're
just
gonna
follow
kill
me to the pavilion, all will be explained.
Okay, no problem.
Excellent. Please, follow me. All will be explained soon.
We're very pleased to see you outside.
All right, let's go. Hurry up, man. Go through a radiated pool. Kind of neat, actually.
Well, You have no idea how overjoyed I am to see you. Normally, outsiders are forbidden inside Oasis, but he has made an exception.
Ooh. Animal friend, hey.
The innocent creatures are drawn here by his gifts. They come from across the wasteland to live in this sanctuary. This part of the world is healing, my friend, and it's all thanks to him. He's no mere god, my friend. He is the one who grows. He is the one who gives. And he is the one who guides. Thanks to him, the tree minders have a home.
Super.
I would have preferred that he made the introduction, but I understand your hesitation. The Great One is a god tree. A living, breathing, speaking god tree.
Or it's a horrible
The tree minders
mutation.
Are blessed to have this being watch over us. We care for this place and keep it safe from those who would seek to exploit it. He gives to us, so we give back to him. It's an arrangement that's worked well for almost 2 decades. We shun technology and embrace nature. That's the life of a tree minder. Sadly, the wasteland is a hostile place, and sometimes we're forced to defend ourselves against it. If that means fighting with manufactured weapons, then so be it.
Do what you
Had
do.
He not asked to see you, you never would have gotten this close to the gates.
Really? I don't believe you.
Yes, indeed it does. Sorry, I don't speak to outsiders very often, and I tend to get lost in conversation. As you approached Oasis, he said you were coming, and I was sent out to meet you personally with a request. He wishes to meet with you. You'd be the first outsider to do so in a very long time.
Yeah, because everybody gets killed by all the crap on the way up here.
Yes, person. To meet him, you must undergo the ceremony of purification. Once that's complete, you'll be able to speak to him. Whenever you're ready, we may begin.
All right.
It's simple, really. You drink the sap from the basin here in the pavilion.
Gross.
The sap will purify your mind and body of anything harmful that could possibly hurt him.
And it could probably make me sick.
I assure you, nothing harmful will happen
nice.
To you. Very good. Take your place in front of the basin, and let's begin.
Okay. Oasis. Let's do it. Why not?
As soon as the rest of the tree minders are in place, we'll
hurry your shit up. Let's go. Drink the sap.
We will now recite the blessing to ward off any harm the outsider may be carrying before he proceeds to the grove.
I bid you depart, agents of destruction, to the power of his divine will.
Leave our homes and bodies immediately. Live no
These
longer
guys are nuts.
Now, but pass over into places where you can harm
nuts and pine cones.
In the name of his frondescence, I call his wrath upon you, so that wherever you may go, you bear it with you.
And diminishing from day to day, you may disappear.
No, not those shriveled black bears.
Doesn't shut the radio down.
May no trace of you be found. All this may he be so good as to grant us. Now, who is to come to judge the living and the dead, and the world by his rigor.
Soon, you will pass peacefully right into sleep outside, and when you awake, you will witness his glory firsthand.
A veritable oasis of green, that depressing sea of brown. Look, it was years ago, and I may have been experimenting with Jet at the time, but I'm telling you, it's out there. Thanks for listening, children.
Holy crap.
This is Three Dog. Ow! And you're listening to Galaxy News Radio. We're Radio Free Wasteland, and we're here for you. Up next, we We've got a public service announcement. Listen up, children. This stuff's important.
I don't know what's here.
We all know the dangers of radiation, but with the right precautions, you can prevent accidental death or even...
Ghoulification.
Keep your eyes on those Geiger counters, kids. Tick, tick, tickety means run your ass out of there, and then pop some rat away for good measure. If you do need to head into the heat, be smart.
Give yourself a nice boost of rat eggs first.
Remember,
here we are.
Only you can prevent human flesh fires.
Holy crap.
Glad to see you're finally awake. I can't believe they made you do that stupid ceremony. They listen when I talk, but they don't hear. You know,
it'd be the other way around, wouldn't it?